working with a picker to open the fleece.
Can you tear this into strips?
Yep, I just showed them to him.
Yeah, like that.
To get it ready to card. It just opens it all up. This is a worse fleece, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's a little bit more clumped together.
My wife just finished the whole thing.
Finger picking is probably what most people do to prepare their fleece. Pickers are not that common. To finger pick, you pull out a bunch of fleece and literally pick it open with your fingers. You can drop it into a bag, make a big pile of it. This is a nice open fleece, so it's very easy to pick apart. While you're doing it, you will look for any vegetable matter or gunk that's in the fleece, pick it out and throw it away. You can see this is a little more glumped together. This is washed fleece, and you can see now it's open and it's ready to be carded. Finger picking. Once the fleece is picked, it's ready to be carded. This can be done on a drum carder or hand cards. These are actually cotton cards. They're very fine. You can see the fine, close teeth on the carding cloth. But they're very good for fine fibers as well as cotton. We need to back up a little bit. One of the articles I read in Spinoff said that the way you card will affect the teeth. So you should always mark one card left and one right. Always hold the one card in your left hand. I can see where this might make a difference. Other people say it doesn't. Just to be on the safe side, I have marked one of my cards with an L for left. You're going to dress the card. Very lightly pull the fiber over. You do not want to glob the fiber on. This does nothing except create a big mess, and it's probably the biggest mistake people make when they hand card. They say they hate to card. Well, it's no wonder. They're trying to wade through a mountain of bad fleece. It's also important that you finger pick the fleece. Carding it is not going to open it. It's just going to get it all nice and neat, like combing your hair. Very light strokes. You don't dig the card down in. Now you're going to transfer from the left card to the right. Put it up at the top and brush it off. Now I'm going to do the same thing again, but I'm going to transfer back to the left card. And now I'm ready to go again. It usually takes about 3, maybe 4 times. Here I go, transferring. Now I'm going to see if I can do it so you can see. Transfer it back. I got that a little far down on the card because I was trying to show the camera. So this is going to need to go an extra time. Again, it should be light work. Now I'm ready to make a roll log. There are a couple ways you can do this. You can do it from the side and roll up across, but I like to do it, and I'm not real good at this. I like to do it from the front. Gently undo your whole carded mass, and then you can roll it a little bit on the card. You want it, it's a nice, airy bit of fiber. You should be able to see through it. And I said, some people take it off and roll it and they're very good at it. I'm not, so don't use that as the best example. This is alpaca. It's a very beautiful kind of a latte colored show fleece from Cienega Creek. And you can see it's nice and open, but I'm going to finger pick it open even a little bit more. Now this has not been washed. Alpaca does not have grease in it like wool. So you can use it before washing. It is, however, very, very dusty. Alpacas like to roll in the dust. And I do prefer to wash my alpaca first, but I didn't get this washed. Again, I'm going to dress the card, the hand cards, very lightly, and start the carding. The fine teeth of the cotton cards are really good for the alpaca because it is such a fine fiber. Basically, what you're doing is just getting all the fibers arranged. And another way you can do it is to kind of smooth it on. I don't know if you can see, I'm just kind of tapping it to loosen it. And here is my roll-off, all ready to spin. It's very easy to draft from this. It's open, it will spin very smoothly. If you have big clumps of fiber, let me do one wrong. We'll go back to the wool. And I'm just going to clump this stuff on here and give it a couple licks and a promise. If you spin junk, you're going to get junk. I think you can see the difference. This is very poorly prepared. There was too much on the cards. I didn't card it long enough. There are big clumps. It also wasn't picked open very well. So there's still big clumps of fiber in here. If I spin this, I'm just going to get a mess. So take your time and prepare your fiber carefully. Another thing you can do with cards or combs is blend different fibers or blend things in. Here's some white wool. You saw me finger pick this a little earlier. And then I'm going to put a little of this dark fiber. Now you can play around with this. I've got it in three little rows. You can totally blend it to get a gray. You can add dashes of color. This is where the fun begins. Again, I'm see if I can hold it up so you can see what I'm doing. I'm just loosening it from the teeth. Now, as I spin this, I'm going to have a little bit of the dark, white, dark, and then here's a little bit more dark at the bottom. Try it. You could do red, white, and blue. You can card in glitz and glitter. You can buy all kinds of things. Cut silk thread into little tiny pieces and put it on the cards and card it in. Your imagination is all that you need to create unique bats and make a unique yarn.